National Security Agency, the agency charged with communications, intelligence, and cryptographic endeavors. So vital to the security of the United States that heretofore public mention of its name was forbidden. The weapon is two-edged. Communications intelligence and communications security.
The production of intelligence. This is kind of old. State of the art has improved since this.
Thousands of people who daily try to gain knowledge about other nations by reading the guarded communications of those nations. And of the other thousands who constantly strive to protect the communications of the United States from the prying eye and the sharply tuned ear of the rest of the world.
I was recruited out of a small Lutheran college in southern Minnesota on August 5th, 1957. That was my first day at work. It was like walking into a brand new world. But techniques have changed. Of course, technology has changed. To me, one of the primary things that has stayed constant throughout the years, that dedication to the mission is a very, very strong, continuing evolution of our effort to the agency.
Something about working in the cryptologic field that gets into the hides of people that work here.
We're known to be code breakers.
Protecting our nuclear codes or looking at how we protect our elections.
People with multiple PhDs and masters in mathematics.
Computer scientists, engineers.
Lawyers and compliance, the analysts, we depend on the mathematicians to be able to break the code. The mathematicians depend on the software developers to create the tools.
New technology, such as artificial intelligence, machine learning.
We have some of the best minds in the country, if not the world, working on getting the systems to be the best that can be.
There is no one mission that is the end-all be-all of national security.
The agency is just a wonderful place to work. You're given the freedom to innovate and create.
You know, they're in a digital foxhole. They're down there every day in their fighting position, and they're providing really exquisite intelligence to help us be able to avoid some of the next conflicts that would cause us trouble.
Well, I really do compliment the people at NSA because I have a chance to see their own enthusiasm, their own confidence. Given the nature of SIGINT, that it will continue to be the bedrock of national intelligence.
Large conflicts that are going on in the world today to other more strategic maneuvers that aren't necessarily known to the public, it's always intelligence that's happening in the background that is going to be there to save the day.
Well, the agency has done some pioneering work. It's a constant push to keep ahead of technology and ahead of the adversary.
We want to ensure that we have the time, the talent, the resources, and that we are invested in the right places to step up to meet the challenges that we continue to face.
The history of SIGINT is a very distinguished history, full of proud and technically talented and operationally talented people doing extraordinary things.
Getting to hear some of my more senior level mentors talk about how the people that mentored them were kind of from that Vietnam era. We had people here doing that signals intelligence mission, and then being able to mentor that next generation that really addressed a lot of the CT focus we have to adapt and overcome. Whether that is cellular communications, different forms of Wi-Fi over the years, or even new encryption methods.
And now we are back to those nation states, but now they use cyber or technology as a means. Gone were the days when we were thinking we're going to have boots on the ground and that would be the only war we would have to fight. Now we are in cyberspace and technology, and that's the war we have to fight.
Just like technology kind of builds on itself, our body of knowledge here in terms of how we go after some of these targets, it builds on itself as well.
It's sort of like a relay. You know, the person on the previous leg that's built everything is handing you the baton and telling you to go with it. You're going to run that race the best you can. So building on the shoulders of giants with everything that we built, and then the next generation taking that and going forward with it, it's quite awesome.
I've acquired great admiration for the people in the agency and for the results it has produced. And I know what the daily requirements of your job are. And I know also of the perils to yourself and to your families of operating in an aura of anonymity.
Overall, we do serve in silence, and to some degree, that can be really challenging.
So even though you can't tell anybody, you still have that sense of pride. Your work or your team's work and somehow shaped what the outcome could have been.
But at the same time, it's really amazing to see the appreciation from our senior leaders coming to our agency to talk to us.
I was always asked by the people who oversee our intelligence and military committees, was, what can we do for your troops? And I want you all to remember that on your rough days when everything seems to be going wrong, that at the end of the day, we're still the greatest hope there is, and you have the respect of so many.
Our objective as an agency is to make tomorrow a boring news story. What we're doing is serving in the shadows and trying to make sure that we're keeping America safe, our allies safe, and our troops overseas safe.
And we see the impact, the real world impact that our work is having when we produce a report that ends up being briefed to the president, or to create new policies that are going to improve our foreign relations, levy sanctions on an adversary, or to be able to support military operations. We find value in what we do by coming together as a group, as one family, for lack of a better term, within the NSA.
I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for all the hours, all the brain power, all the energy that you have provided to do that job. There is no finer group of people serving the American people than the people at NSA.
But we're starting to see a whole nother set of adversaries that don't play by the rules.
The word adversary, somebody is always planning something with malintent.
China is a pacing threat, and it's not going anywhere. Then we have Russia, the urgent priority because of Russia and Ukraine. And we have election security, which is our priority right now. And then we have other threats and cyber criminals, people who use ransomware as their means to get what they want to get.
Faced against adversaries that don't want to play by the rules, the NSA takes on that fight, motivated to protect America and its allies.
We don't do things the way some other countries do it. And sometimes that makes it more expensive or more difficult, but over the long term, that's why we win. We win not just because we're good at what we do, but we win because we do things the right way.
The NSA has the power to respond and be proactive. We have the power, we have the people, and we have the love for the mission on our side.
No one came here for the money. They came here for the mission.
It's the ultimate team sport. Whether you have on like a floral print, Hawaiian print, you're wearing chevrons, you got a business suit on, you got a camouflage pattern, none of that really matters. The report doesn't care who writes it. You know, good analysis doesn't care who does it, whether that's a civilian, military, or contractor. So I think that's a real strength for us here at the agency.
I see no reason why we can't continue to innovate and build on what's to come in the future.
All of the work that we do, which informs not only our partners, but also our decision makers and warfighters, it gives us a lot of pride, and we know that it's a lot of responsibility on our shoulders. But America can sleep at night because our mission never sleeps.
Signals intelligence, cybersecurity, bringing those two critical missions, the ability to break code and to make code, is what our agency does so well. As we think about our nation as it looks to the future, an ability to remain the preeminent global power is going to rest on what our agency can do.